Hey guys and girls, welcome to episode 7 of Champion Connections. I'm your host, Chris Coleman. Today, we have a guest hailing from Philadelphia who's a singer, a writer, a dancer, and a musician. It's all self-taught. Now, today's guest calls himself the Voice Bender. He's making a name for himself, and watch out, he's gonna be doing some great things. Tune in as he talks about some of his struggles, some of his ups and downs, some of his victories, and where he's going in the next 5 years. I know you don't want to miss this one.
I am Julian Coleman, and I'm a student at the University of the Arts. It's my last year. Singer, dancer. I teach voice lessons. I teach hip-hop classes. I play piano, guitar. I'm signed to a label called 2020, which is Philadelphia-based. And right now I'm working. I also work at Apple retail store in King of Prussia Mall, and I'm just constantly on the grind.
Alright, so being that you do so many things, a lot of people always say, oh my god, I work a 9-to-5, I have no time to do A, B, and C, or I'm in school and I have no time to like do this, that, and the third. How do you manage your time doing all of those different things?
It's tough. I've kind of been blessed, I guess. Everything that I do kind of works itself out. And I mean, I'm not diagnosed with it, but I think I have like OCD when it comes to like scheduling and stuff. No, literally, like I have the entire month of August already planned out. And I mean, like I'm at Apple, but I'm there part-time. So like, and in my department at the store, there's so many of us. So it's easy for me to like find shift swaps or get extra hours if I want them. So that's been a blessing. And then it's the summer, so I'm not really in school right now. And then between studio, getting a haircut, teaching classes and voice lessons outside of my... It's just like, it's all worked itself out. I guess, I don't know. Like, I've always been good with time management. And I guess that started when I had to start catching public transportation. So I had to start planning ahead of time. And now I plan weeks and months in advance.
Yeah, that's some good stuff, man. Like... Yeah. Balancing your calendar is probably like the difficult
time. My calendar, I promise you, is the best thing to do right now. It's the best thing.
All
right,
so musician, artist, dancer, were you always growing up like, I want to be a musician, or I want to sing, or I want to perform, or I want to dance? Or did you just stumble upon this gift that you have?
I didn't want to be a singer. I didn't want to be a dancer. I didn't want to play instruments at all. So what happened was I wanted to be like a vet or a chef. And I was like, in my head, I was like, okay, I'm going to go to school and then I'm going to have like all these dogs and start like this like SPCA kind of sort of. And then I was going to go to culinary school and then become a chef. This was around the time like I was getting ready to go to Masterman. So I was like, oh, this would be perfect. Like, go to one of the top schools in the city. My academics take me there. It should be a no-brainer. And then I sang. I think one of the first times I sang was, like, at church. I was singing Mary, Mary, Shackles on My Feet, and it was really bad. Like, I used to be really bad. Like, I was screeching. I was cracking. It was horrible. And, like, everybody, you know, everybody at church is like, oh, my God, yeah. You sound amazing. Yeah, well, it sounded horrible. But the feeling that I got when I did that, I was like, whoa, like I could do this forever and ever. So I kept doing it and kept doing it. And I kept involving myself through middle school and then went to Catholic and the UArts and stuff and just got better. So I never in a million years thought I was going to be like, you know, like every time I saw a DVD of an artist or like, you know, the award shows on TV, I'd be like, whoa, like that's what's up. But yeah. I never was like, no. But then I tried it and I liked it and I actually was good at it. So I was like, oh, let me continue to do this. Like, I could do this for real. And then that was it.
So how'd you learn to play multiple instruments? Are you self-taught? Well, I mean, obviously it's not like...
Yeah, mostly self-taught piano. When I did get to UArts, I started like... I took 2 piano classes. And then from that, I kind of like just kept going. Guitar is kind of like self-taught, plus I have an instructor who teaches me, so...
Cool.
But I'm better in piano than I am in guitar. I'm just like, recently I've been starting guitar, but it's been cool.
Didn't even know you played guitar, by the way.
Yeah, I only did that because like, as a singer, it's really hard to like find musicians all the time. So that was the only reason I even learned how to play piano, because it was like, I never could get someone to play with me.
Got it.
So it was just like, oh, well, I'll be able to do my own songs.
For sure. So can you, a lot of people think, like, you know, Beyonce became the superstar she is just mm-hmm. like overnight, or like Jay-Z became the rapper he is like overnight. And mm-hmm. I guess people deter themselves from going after their dreams because it's like, well, they're famous and they have all this money. That's why they can do this, that, and the third. But can you talk about how you've created opportunities for yourself, whether it's performances, whether it's publications, whether it's photo shoots, whatever, without, you know, any budget, without necessarily knowing anybody, and just actually doing it?
This industry is so hard. Like, it's not like one of them things where, like, you go to this school, then you get your undergrad, then you get your master's, and your PhD, and then your doctorate, and then boom, you get a job.
Yeah.
It's like a constant thing. I'm say, like, I started really getting into it when, like, 6th, 7th grade at Masterman with, like, the musicals and stuff. And then all the way up until I went to high school, all the way through high school, and even now with me getting ready to graduate at UArts, it's been a constant thing. Like, with the arts, it's all about, like, who you know instead of what you know. So I constantly involved myself in everything. Like, I was almost like a triple major at Kappa just because I wanted to be in the dance scene, be in the vocal scene, be in the acting scene. And then being in those scenes, I met people. And like today, I'm not even where I want to be, but I'm pretty good, and I'm kind of like well known around the city, and like I'm busy and I'm doing things, but it took forever to get to this spot. Like, not every day that I get to be where I am, and I'm not even there yet, but I'm getting, you know, closer. Yeah. Like, I remember when I didn't have places to sing, I didn't have places to dance, I didn't know how to do this, I didn't know how to do that, and now, like, you know, it's kind of worked out in my favor to just be involved in as much as possible and constantly working. Like, a lot of, it's been a lot of sacrifice because all of my free time goes into my craft. So, I mean, every now and then, like, I would enjoy going swimming or going to a party or something like that. But for the most part, I'm always in the studio. I'm always in a rehearsal. I'm always at a show. I'm always in an intensive dancing, teaching something if I'm not at work. And it's truly been a blessing. It really has. It's just a constant. It's a constant thing. Like, and as I talk to like Beyonce's head creative, and as I talk to these different artists who I like come across, it's been a constant thing with them too. Like, nothing ever happens overnight. Like, even Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber came out in 2008. He was discovered in 2006. And a few months later, it took him like a year and a half living in Atlanta, homeless pretty much, before he even came out with his first single, which is like, I forgot the name of it, but you know what I mean.
Yeah.
It does not happen overnight.
I always love the story of Justin Bieber because, like, people hate that man. I don't know why. I think he's one of the most talented people out there.
I think I hated him when he first came out, but I think it was just, like, a little jealousy. Like, why is he, why does he have what I want? You know, like, yeah. It was just like, yeah. But I'm in a good position. I'm not worried. He's talented. You know, there definitely are some behavior issues going on right now, but, hey, every artist goes through that phase.
Sure. Can you talk about, you mentioned you were speaking with Beyonce's creative. I've seen you leveraging social media like a lot to make connections and build relationships. Can you talk about how you definitely can leverage technology to build yourself up?
So nowadays, like, everything is technology, right? And it's funny, the power that we hold and we don't even know. Like, there will be random days where I'm like watching a YouTube video and I'm like, yo, this artist is killing. And I would tweet them. And then by me tweeting, I would get like 20 retweets and like all these favorites and all this stuff. And then you yourself kind of like grow more and more and more. And I've seen it happen like over and over. Like, some days, some nights is really random. Like, some nights I'm like praying. And I'm like, let me start praying for some people who actually need prayer. So like, I would randomly start tweeting like Niecy Nash and musical directors and dancers and stuff, and they actually would reply. And by them replying, it has created like a way to talk to these people who we thought that we never could talk to.
Yeah.
And to this day, like, I talked to Beyonce's musical director and her background singers, and I'm friends with some of her dancers, like, by just doing things like that. And it kind of has opened doors. Like, I never in a million years would have thought that, like, by tweeting the Philadelphia Grammy chapter, would I have attended the Grammys this year. And then I'm getting ready to go to Justin Timberlake's soundcheck when he comes to Philly. Because, like, I met them through this medium. Like, you never know what's going to happen. And, like, it's crazy. It really is crazy. And I guess it also has helped because Philly's music scene is kind of like, it's kind of like all over the place, but when you meet one person, they know one person, and they know one person, and like, his background singer is Jill Scott's background singer, who is the musical director for Justin Timberlake, who I'm going to see on that Tuesday, you know, so it's just like, social media has kind of like connected all of us in a world where we think that there's no connection at all, which is ironic, because we, like, social media holds so much power, even on like Instagram. I'll post different photos, and like, put all these random hashtags, and get connected with people like from all over the world. You know, it's crazy. Like, it's crazy.
You got a nice little following on both of those, man.
No. Literally, like, I don't know how. I mean, like, I'm pretty okay on YouTube. Like, I have a lot of views and stuff. So recently, like, I've been putting all that social stuff on there. So I've been seeing an influx of, you know, but it's just about connecting, like. I try to connect with as many people as possible because you never know who someone is.
So true. It's crazy. So crazy.
Have
you, you know, people always say when you're going, or I should say this, when you're going after your dreams, obviously you become a different person because your journey, like, changes you. You become a better person than you were yesterday. Have you experienced people saying, like, oh, you're not the same guy that I knew like 5 years ago, or like some of your friends are saying like you're different.
As you change, you kind of start to see people around you change. And that can be a good thing and it can be a bad thing. For me, before I even started this journey, I was just that kid who went outside and played Manhunt and who every day went to the corner store before school. And, like, that was my life. And so I had decided that I wanted to change it and I wanted to pursue something. And my circle of friends started changing to my friends who, like, are in the industry now. And I think that I have definitely seen a change within myself, and it's probably within, like, my level of focus and determination. Also, with this industry, it kind of, like, can make you impatient, and sometimes I'm a little bit emotionally unstable because a lot of things get your hopes up high and then they're dropped. So then you have to deal with that, and you have to deal with tons of no's, and you have to deal with tons of this and tons of that. I think that because my schedule is so busy sometimes, I often find myself getting like very impatient with people sometimes, or because I'm so tired, I'd just rather go on my run and be like antisocial or stuff like that. But it's only because I'm working to build myself. I think that, like I said earlier, as you change, you start seeing the people change around you. And a lot of times that's for the good. You know, like, a lot of people who pursue their dreams and their goals find out that their circle of friends 5 or 6 months later from that point are different than what it was. And I'm a firm believer in, like, keeping people around you who really believe in you and who really, like, see your goal just as clear as you see it. And I haven't, like, at first it was hard for me to deal with because I'm like, my best friends leave me, now all these people hate me, and blah, blah, blah. But God knows what he's doing. Like, it truly has worked itself out, and I now have no worry, you know? And now, like, if I don't make it to a birthday party or an event, or if I don't get back to you or something like that, people know it's because I'm always in a rehearsal, at a show, doing this and doing that. And everyone, I'm kind of known as, like, Mr. Busy because I'm always, you know. So whatever situation you are in, it kind of works itself out for your better good, you know.
So can you speak on, I guess, a specific moment or obstacle that you've that's come your way, and how the new you has jump that hurdle or attack that obstacle compared to when you were first beginning your journey?
Obstacle. Wow. I think the hardest obstacle, which was a life-changing moment for me, was when I actually went to a different school, which was Wilberforce University. I got there in Ohio, and it just was not the school for me. So I came back home. I had nothing to do. I had no job. I had no money. My family was mad because I came home, and that was a full ride that I left. So it was just like, it looked like I had black clouds following me.
Yeah.
And I was at a really, really low point in life. Like, I had nothing going on musically, no source of income, no schooling. I was stuck in that little room upstairs. Like, it was just horrible. And that moment in my life, I realized that it was time to kick up the gears. A lot of times, like, during middle school and high school, we take for granted how much people do for us and how much the school district does for us and how much everything is really taken care of. And so I really had to, like, grow up. And I'm glad that moment in my life happened because it kind of redirected my focus to making sure that I would be okay. So that's when I got the job at Apple. That's when I auditioned at University of Arts, got a great scholarship, and went. And it's still going there. And then I started connecting more. I joined different chapters, and I joined this, and went to so many events to kind of like get my name out there. And I am where I am now. That low point in my life has made me more focused, has made me more determined, has made me more independent. And it's hard because, like, amongst everything I'm doing, I still have to work because I still have to eat. So that's my job at Apple. And I'm teaching lessons in hip-hop, so then that's income. And I'm having to pay for school by myself, which has been the hardest thing. But it has all worked itself out with the amount of gigs that I've gotten, to musicals, to singing background for different artists. And it's just worked itself out. But that point in my life really changed me. That was a defining moment. It was like, it changed my level of focus. It also changed my maturity and my artistry. And it made my story deeper, I will say.
Definitely makes you more relatable to, like, every other person out here.
Yeah, like, it will, once I get where I get, it will truly make me appreciative. Like, it was to the point where, like, I had no money to eat some days, and or some days I'd be at school, like, how the heck am I going to eat? I don't have enough money, and where am I going to get this, and how am I going to get Transpass, and now I need money for books, and blah, blah. Like, it was just one thing after another. But you just got to keep going. And, like, I heard the saying, like, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And for the longest, it was just like, that's a bunch of BS. Like, I don't care about that. But it is so true. Like, I thought that I would never be doing everything that I'm doing and getting to graduate on my own. Like, I thought I'd never, like, I'm in school full-time and I'm working full-time hours at Apple. And I'm still paying for it by myself. And I'm still having a life. I'm pursuing my music. And I'm still able to purchase things for myself. Like, I never thought that I would be where I am right now.
It's amazing, like, when the human mind actually gets set on doing something, like, the things that we can do.
And it's crazy because during this whole process up until now, with the whole social media stuff, I would take, like, small little breaks from it. So I'd be gone for, like, a week or gone for, like, 2 weeks or even a month, just see how much work I get. And I would set different goals for myself. And it was the most fantastic thing. Like, don't get me wrong, social media definitely is a huge thing for me as an artist, especially, like, with YouTube and all the people that I can reach Twitter-wise, all of the artists and musical directors and producers and stuff that I talk to via social media. But it's amazing when you set a goal for yourself and you actually achieve it, the amount of appreciation you have towards yourself. It's crazy.
So, all right, enough about the bad parts. Let's talk about some of your successes. You mentioned you went to the Grammys. You performed at the Kimmel Center.
Definitely.
What would you say is one of the biggest highlights so far of your upcoming music career? or acting or dancing career?
The biggest highlight. I went to the Grammys, which is very inspiring, man. Like, I was sitting next to Mary Mary and Esperanza Spalding and like Chick Corea and like Taylor Swift. It was crazy. That was pretty inspiring. I did a musical at the Kimmel Center, part of the Philadelphia International Festival of the Arts, and ended up having like this solo that kind of like closed out the thing. They wrote the finale for my voice.
Oh, wow, that's kind of cool.
That experience was like frustrating because it was a whole new world for me. But if we were done at the end of April, man, I miss it so much. It's crazy.
You guys were on the news too, right? Good Morning America,
yeah,
was it?
We were on Channel 3 here in Philly. It was like a Talk Philly segment. And we sang Flash of Time, which was the finale. And it was, man, it was amazing. I think the highlight for me, wow, there's so many highlights. But the thing that I'm thinking about, I just think about my situation and what I'm in with, like, the managers who I'm working with and the producers that I'm working with and the label that I'm working with. I think another highlight has been intertwined with that. I don't know how, but I am in connection with so many different artists and so many different producers. Like, Beyonce's creative musical director, I talked to. I talked to Jill Scott. I talked to Donnie McClurkin. I talked to dancers and background singers and MDs from all over, and it's kind of helped my career. It's kind of helped me emotionally and like psychologically. It's also been a motivation of mine to like keep going. It's crazy because at 20 years old, I've accomplished so much, and I'm in connection with so many different people. And I'm just in a good place where I can continue to keep going without having to worry about too much doubt and too much, you know.
Sure.
And it has been a struggle up until now. Like, not every day was I emailing Jill Scott. Not every day was I calling Donnie McClurkin. Not every day was I tweeting Beyonce's creative team, you know. But it's so humbling because I'm already in connection with them, and I haven't even catapulted to where I know God is going to take me. You know, and I don't really have any major highlight other than, you know, the things that I just stated, because I'm still going. And I mean, I've sung for Obama and sung for this person and that person and all over and did parades, and it's been a lot, but I still haven't gotten to where I see myself, so I think my highlight has kind of been my journey recently. Like, maybe as of this year. This year has just been crazy. From the show I did on my birthday in January, to the Grammys, to the musical, to almost singing background for Jill Scott, to all the concerts that I'm going to getting ready to meet Justin Timberlake in a few weeks, to getting ready to be done with school, to getting ready to get my distribution to a major label. This year has kind of been, I feel like this year has been in preparation for something big. Like, I really feel like 2014 is my year. The year that I graduate, the year that I get my major distribution label, the year that I just, you know. And it has been crazy because this has been like, I guess like my whole entire years at University Arts have kind of been like a molding zone without me even knowing it. Like, I didn't even know I would be at the school. You know?
Very true.
And I think that it was the moment when I stopped trying to, like, control everything myself and really let God kind of, like, take over, or, you know, whatever kind of religious anyone believes in. Really just, like, you don't really have to do anything alone in this life. It's crazy. You have to work, don't get me wrong. There's so many people around you who are trying to achieve their dreams and trying to achieve their goals. And if you just connect, like, you feed off each other's energy and it gets you through, like, it's crazy. So my highlight has kind of been like my journey thus far this year. That's knowing what 2014 is getting ready to bring me is crazy.
It sounds like you're laying right on the tipping point. Like,
dude, like, I still get shocked sometimes myself. Like last week when they asked me to come to the Justin Timberlake soundcheck, I was like, "Are you serious?" Like, because I'm already going to the concert, and I actually bought Rashid tickets for his birthday.
Yeah.
So I was already going to be there, but I got invited to the soundcheck to talk to him and meet with him. Like, it's crazy. It's crazy. Like things like that. It's just like, okay, now it's going to keep me going. And then when I actually sit down and talk to him, I know it's just going to re-inspire me and re-motivate me. Like, it's amazing.
I'm feeling it. Like, the laws of attraction, man. Like, this makes me want to, like, keep going what I'm doing.
And it sucks sometimes, dude. Like, literally, I don't even always get to see my family. Like, most times I come in the house, I may eat, but I shower and I go to bed. Get up early in the morning, do what I need to do, come home super late, and do it over and over. Like, I barely see my family. But it's so rewarding. It's so rewarding. Like, I wouldn't imagine it any other way.
I feel that, man. All right, this is a kind of a different question, but, like, art. Very personal. It's very, like, supposed to be from within, and like it's probably one of the most opinionated or most criticized things out there. How did you, like, as an artist, deal with people critiquing your work, whether it's positively or negatively, as well as taking that step out and saying, hey, I want to promote my work to the world, I want to sign with this artist so we can funnel my work to the masses?
I know for myself personally, like, at first it was just like, man, what are you talking about? Like, I'm gonna do this. Like, who are you? You don't even sing, you know?
Yeah.
And it wasn't until I really started having, like, sit downs with a lot of artists, a lot of producers and songwriters. And there's a difference between being a you know what and actually providing constructive criticism.
Yeah.
And throughout my productions, I have learned the pros and cons of fearless feedback. And it has kind of shaped my artistry today. You know, like, it's an ongoing thing for me. Like, some days I'll get critiqued and I'm just like, yo, like, oh, that's perfect. Like, that's actually just what I needed. And then in some days where it's just like, I actually really didn't need you to tell me that. Not that I would say that to them.
Yeah,
but
yeah, yeah.
It's just like, just leave me alone. And I may have been having a bad day or something. But I know for myself, like, I'm always trying to find ways to get better. Like, I constantly am watching, like, YouTube videos and mocking people and, like, making different set lists for shows that I don't even have planned, or, like, always taking a dance class or teaching a dance class or teaching a voice lesson or trying to sing background for this artist or flying here to do this. And do, like, I'm constantly trying to get better. So now I'm at a point where I'm not afraid of fearless feedback. I actually love it.
Fair enough. Fair enough. All right. What would you say was your biggest fear when you first started this whole journey?
Biggest fear.
For some, it's
I think it's kind of like a two-part thing. I think my biggest fear was that no one would really like me, and I wouldn't really make it. I think it's one of the hardest things that an artist has to do, because before you get signed to, like, your major distribution and all of that, it's a waiting game. So you become impatient, you become frustrated, you become downed. And no one wants to have that fear of not achieving their goals. It's probably one of the scariest things, especially when you have a job that's kind of like this, and it's kind of like this because you've been spending so much time trying to push yourself to achieve your goals. And it's kind of like that faith or fate moment where it's just like, you can do it or you can just fail. And that was a huge struggle for me. And sometimes it still is today. Like, sometimes I'll go to my artist development coaching, like, bummed out. Like, I don't want to do this. Why is this taking forever? I can't do this. I can't do that. Why am I not here? Blah, blah, blah. But it wasn't until I really realized that everything is going to happen the way God wants it to happen. I'm a person who, like I told you, I plan my months out, my weeks out. Like, I need to know what I'm doing, how I'm going to do this. I set goals. I do this and do that. But this is like one of them things where it's going to happen at the right time.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Like when I think about when Beyonce came out after Destiny's Child's huge success and all the solo acts around her genre at that time, it was her time to come out and now she's here. Or how like all the boy bands and stuff were dying down and all the kid teen bops were kind of like non-existent. And then Justin Bieber came out and now Justin Bieber's on top, you know? So I'm a firm believer that everything happens for a reason and everything will happen during God's time. And then in my artist development, I've kind of figured out who I am and who I want to be artistry. So in like worrying about if people will like me or not, people are already going to like you just because of who you are and like your personality and your work ethic, because work ethic speaks way more than you ever saying, I can do this, I can do that. So those two are probably my hugest fears. And not saying that I haven't already overcome them, because it's a constant thing. Like, some days I'm just like, I hate my voice. Some days I'm just like, this is never going to happen for me. Some days I'm like, why are all these people on the BET Awards and I'm not? You know, like, I can do this, I can do that, I've done this. You know, it's a constant thing.
Fair enough, man. I truly can say, like, it always, I don't want to say it saddens me, but like, people that are quote unquote not talented, but yet they found a way to market what they're doing and now they're experiencing like huge success. Whereas guys like you who have like put in their time and like you, it's very obvious that you're a very talented singer and dancer. It's like, well, why can't this guy get a chance? So like,
yeah, I think after knowing what I know about this industry, it all makes sense. Yet it still is a little frustrating to have to like, you know, sit and watch. But in that frustration and that kind of doubtfulness or kind of like flipping that fear, it has motivated me and inspired me to just keep going. And in my quest of keep going, I've achieved more just by keep going. You know, it's crazy.
Sure. All right, so I know we're running out of time. I don't want to keep you too long, but what would you say for someone that's like just starting out or thinking about pursuing dance, music, being a chef, starting a business, whatever? What words of advice would you give someone?
Wow. Well, one thing of advice I would give is to change your work ethic. A lot of times people just like, oh, I work a 9-to-5 and I want my body to look right, but I'm tired, I don't want to go to the gym. It's those moments that matter and that will make you stronger. And there have been days where I have been at school from 7:30 in the morning until 3. I've stayed after school until 6:30 for rehearsals. I then went to dance until 9:30. And then at 9:30, I went to the gym until 10:30, 11 o'clock to have to wake up and do it all again. It's those moments that make us stronger. It's those moments that change the mindset. And just like that book, The Slight Edge, you know, once you change your mindset, your reality changes subconsciously. It's crazy. So definitely change the way that you work. Also take advantage of every opportunity, whether you think the opportunity is going to help you in the long run or you think it's just a waste of time. Staying busy also keeps you out of trouble. And I think that my schedule has worked itself to be busy just to keep me out of trouble so that I could stay focused and I could stay motivated and determined to do what I wanted to do. I was dancing, I was singing, I was acting. I was pretty much tiring myself out. That way I could wake up and do it all over again. But in the meantime, I was getting so much better. And just know that it's a continuous thing. And know that you have people around you who are feeling the same way. So I would also just connect with people so that you can grow on this journey. I get a lot of like emails and messages, especially like on YouTube, like, what advice can you give me for, like, I want to be a singer and I want to be getting gigs like you and traveling like you and doing this and doing that. But it honestly has just been applying myself and really getting involved in as much as possible. Now, even in my spare time, with the little that I do have, I'm volunteering at the Ronald McDonald House. And that has kind of been like a freeing thing, because most times on my downtime, I'm just like upset, I'm irked, I'm tired, I'm this and that. But it's kind of like created like a balance with what I'm doing. So by you just sending out your energy, you never know. Like, all the time, I'm at work, and some days it's just like, oh, this is just for Apple retail, I really don't want to do this. Yet, we have basketball players that come into the store. I literally upgraded one of the guys from the Root cell phone at the King of Prussia Apple store. So you never know, by you taking advantage of every opportunity and every little thing that you do, who you're going to cross paths with. And in this industry, it's so important with who you know instead of what you know, literally. Like, by you just applying yourself and taking advantage of everything that you're doing and really doing everything to your best ability, not only will you become a better person, not only will you stay inspired and motivated, but at the end of the day, you'll be a better human being. And your work ethic will speak for itself outside of your talent. Because if people see your work ethic, then they're going to really want to know what your talent is. And then it's a no-brainer after that. There are days where you are going to feel like this is a piece of crap and I don't want to do this, and I'll just go work at Kohl's or JCPenney, or I don't know. Those are really random stories I just thought of. But you get what I mean.
Like, yeah.
It's really amazing as I'm telling you this now, because this is exactly how I felt. Like, crappy. There will be days that I cried. There were days where I just cursed out loud and just three things all over the place, but you wake up just ready to just do it again, and it's amazing. Like, I think about where I was, like, just a few years, like 2010, 2011, and where I am now, and the circle of friends and opportunities and things that have come my way and are still coming and working themselves out. It's only because I changed my mindset. It's only because I changed the way that I thought, the way that I spent my money, the way that I spent my time, the way that I allowed my friends to play roles in my life. It was a huge thing. I'd rather be lonely and happy than surrounded by a whole bunch of crap and unhappy, you know? So once you change your mindset, your reality changes. It's a no-brainer.
It's funny you say that, because like, that has seemed to be one of the common themes from all the people that I interviewed. It's like, the road to success is literally the same no matter what you're doing. It's just you apply different aspects to whatever you're doing. And like, changing the mindset was usually one of the big things people said. How you think, perception becomes reality. So
exactly. Because if you don't keep going, you could say, you could give up right before the next thing was your big break.
Yep.
You know? And I've seen that happen. I have seen someone give up on singing. And Kelly Rowland was just getting to call her to be her background singer. And she just didn't want to do it. Changed her number. Deleted all her social stuff. Like, it's crazy. Just keep going. It's so fulfilling at the end. Like, it's so fulfilling. Like, and things take time at the end of the day. Like, I in my head thought that, like, people just got signed to labels. And then after they got signed to labels, you just jump out on a tour and you get signed in January, and you're selling out Madison Square Garden in March, and then you're winning Grammys in September. No. It does not. Nothing happens like that.
Yeah. Even in the tech industry, a lot of people don't know, Angry Birds, which was created by Rovo, was actually their 35th game created over 6 years. And no one remembers the ones that didn't make it, but look at Angry Birds now. So. Mm-hmm. Once again, man, let everyone know where they can find you. videos, Twitter, Facebook, whatever.
Yeah, you go to YouTube, just search in Julian Coleman. They used to have like a username thing, but they kind of like took that away.
Yeah, so now
weird, you just
now. Like,
search the person's first and last name. It's just actually kind of good, because some of those names are a little ratchet. But regardless, just search up Julian Coleman on YouTube. You'll see my channel. I think I'm in a picture of like a hat turned that way. I don't know. And then on Twitter and Instagram, I am The Voice Bender, T-H-E, Voice, V-O-I-C-E, Bender. Bender. Do you know where that's from?
No.
All right, so there's a show, The Avatar: The Last Airbender.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
You know how like it's like air, water, earth, and fire.
Yeah.
Well, I was like, since I'm a singer, I was like the voice bender. Get it? Like, whatever.
That's one of my favorite shows, though. Yeah. Not gonna lie.
Yeah. That's Instagram and Twitter, the voice bender, and then on Facebook, if you still want to, Julian Terrell Coleman, I'm on there. And if you ever want like any advice or anyone to talk to or a mentor or XYZ, just email me. My email is Julian Terrell, J-U-L-I-A-N, Terrell, T-R-R-E-L-L, @me.com. So just email me, hit me up.
There it is. Guys, look out for this guy next year. He's breaking out and doing big things. I mean, he's already doing big things in my eyes, but we all know he wants to do more. Let everyone know, I guess, what's your five-year goal? What do you see yourself in 5 years?
5 years, I definitely will be signed. I'm signed right now to this label called 2020, which is Philadelphia-based. After that, I'm going to have my distribution deal through, hoping, Sony and Columbia, cross fingers. Once that's done, I mean, I'll be touring. After I really establish myself musically, I kind of want to set up a center for the arts that gives the ability for everything. All the abilities, all the opportunities that I didn't have, I kind of want to give that back. It probably will happen probably after that first 5 year mark, because the first 3 to 5 years of an artist is pretty much like building yourself. So I definitely see myself on award shows. I'll be signed. And I'll be traveling, so I may even be in a city near you.
There it is. Remember the name, Julian Coleman, the voice bender. Once again, man, thank you for taking the time to talk with me.
My pleasure, man. I love this stuff.
And you're very inspiring. Keep doing what you're doing, man, and lead by example. That's all I can say, man.
Thank you.
Wow. Wasn't that a great episode? Listen, ladies and gentlemen, if you're interested in going after anything in life, just go for it. I don't know if you can learn anything, if you took anything away from it, but I did. Now apply it to your own life, and I can guarantee that you'll see more success. Now, next Thursday, or this Thursday, we have a dancer who was a mad scientist before, but changed his major while in college to dancing. He talks about the different things that happened while looking for his passion, once he found his passion, and where he's headed now. So if you're a creative person, if you're a dancer, musician, or if you just are interested in being inspired, check it out. You don't want to miss it. And make sure you subscribe to get all the latest updates. I bet you thought your computer froze, didn't you? But no, make sure you subscribe. Let us know what you like and what you don't like about the episodes, and anything we can do to improve it. And if you know any Champion Connections, feel free to send us an email, a tweet, or respond to us on Facebook.